What's up, guys? Back on the server. We upgraded our tractor from 270 to 300. We also sold our old planter and picked up the horse Maestro. It's 3 meters wider than our old one, and the capacity for seed and fertilizer is quite a bit. Quite a bit of an improvement. We also picked up the John Deere 2100 Ripper. It's what we use to plow now. And we picked up Field 9 and made it part of Field 5. And so, finished planting. All the crops are ready to go here. I don't know why this went so slow. Eating an apple right now, so if it's loud and crunchy, I apologize. Bit more efficient. I don't have my IR turned on, so I'm just using my mouse today. Last time we did corn, so I think now we'll tie in here with that tractor. I'm gonna take our 36-foot header and do some beans. Nice turnout so far, 4 minutes into the stream, and there's 26 people watching. Alright. So we're gonna go down to our small field first. Let's get that over and done with. This is just a default map with chop straw installed into it. It actually adds a fertilization stain when you cultivate or plow it under. we're slowly kind of trading in all of our smaller starting equipment and buying up more land, more larger, more modern equipment. I think we're actually completely done with all of the initial equipment we've since then purchased in upgraded machines. I think our next machine will probably be like a 340 case, just because that Optum is just a hair. I mean, it can pull the 2100, but it's just slightly underpowered. Should be able to pull up to a maximum of like 12 miles an hour in game. Not very realistic, but the engine specs on that Optum is can only pull at maximum 6 miles an hour, typically across the fields. A little bit bigger tractor will help with the plowing. None of these fields are plowed, so we're not going to get that plowed boost. I think it's only like a 10% boost for plowing. But it has all three fertilization states. So the yield should be pretty. I think we usually get right around 4,000, 3,500 liters out of this field of beans. Be wrong. It's not a very big field, and soybeans only yield, you know, 50-60 bushel an acre if you're doing it right. I think I have this map spec at 60 bushel an acre. Ask me why I don't use Twitch. I don't know anything about Twitch. I don't understand Twitch. I mean, YouTube has its own live stream. That's what I'm doing right now. So I don't. It just seems like another redundant thing that doesn't make sense to me. I mean, YouTube works fine. The only downside with the YouTube is it kind of uploads my stream to YouTube as I'm streaming it, so it takes up more bandwidth, so I think I'm more prone to lagging streaming on YouTube. I mean, I don't have the fastest internet in the world, but it's pretty decent. never asked me why I don't give all my mods away. I don't really see people asking other YouTubers why don't they give their mods away. So people with a lot more subscribers than myself that don't do mods at all, so I don't see why that's a necessary thing for YouTubers. If you want it, you should make it. That's what I did. Or ask Giants. Giants, they're the ones that make money on the game. You're the one that bought the game. So just go on mods, ask Giants. Should be more than willing to make a DLC for you guys that you can purchase. So that was our little fields, 5600. How do you get Chop Straw to work? You read the instructions that come with the mod. You have to install it in the map and then put the actual mod in the mods folder. Hopefully with that new field we picked up, hopefully we're getting closer to 100,000 liters of beans in our harvest. If we were to put our cornfield beans, we'd definitely be right there at the 100,000 liters, I think. But it's always nice to grow a couple of variety of crops. So we were farming with a 25-foot Massey Ferguson draper on the case 1060 or 66 or whatever it was, the old red combine you first started with. And then bumping up, this is the 36-foot MacDon draper. Doesn't seem that big, but it's just because we have a 7130 combine now. It's quite a bit bigger than the original combine. So it makes fairly quick work of the fields. We do have the option to go up to a 45-foot MacDon draper, but that's just too large for this size of combine. That's more for a Class 9, Class 10 combine. Our auger's barely long enough on the 7130 to get past the 36-foot trailer. But I'm sure we'll get up there eventually, maybe like the 92 series 45-foot. Maybe I'll, by that time I'll have a John Deere combine out of blender and convert it over. People ask me if I, what kind of brand I like. I don't really have a preference. I like all things mechanical, really. I think Case New Holland, John Deere, Challenger. They're all good. It really depends on kind of price point you can get it at, what kind of luck you have, liability-wise, what kind of service you have access to. If you live in an area, the closest Case IH dealer is like 200 miles away, it doesn't really make sense to have a fleet of Case IH equipment. John Deere, New Holland is 10 miles away. I've also been watching, I believe his name is Cotton Top 3, something like that. He's a guy that does a bunch of logging. Makes quite a few videos pretty frequently. So it's nice to watch a little bit of logging instead of just farming all the time. So I changed the unload rate of this combine to spec. It's like 142 liters a second. That was what Case IH was spec'd out at. It always bothered me how the unloading speeds are like four times what they really should be. Tipping and unloading augers and grain carts. See if you guys are asking any more questions here. Apparently we're having a bad night for the stream. Remember back in 15, I was trying to do a live stream with the course plate and kept cutting out. It says the stream health is green. Good now. Thank you. You don't find the mods I have in my game. I don't download mods. I either make them myself or I edit the in-game equipment myself. The only mods I ever download are scripts, like drive control and GPS and stuff like that. I don't actually download any vehicle or trailer mods like that, so. If you see stuff in my game, you usually can't get it unless it's for 15. If you're watching a 15 video, then I've released quite a few of those ones. Mostly because after you've been around this game for 3-4 years, you learn that most of the stuff out there is not worth your time downloading. Models are either junk, or textures are junk, or scripting is terrible. Next thing you know, you buy someone else's work, you try to use it, log back into your save game, and all of your vehicles are gone. So I've learned my lesson, and I just kind of put in the time into it myself. They released another version of the Chop Straw, so maybe they kind of fixed that issue. But it was like this in 15 and 13, so it always kind of left a space. So who really knows? Yeah, where is Jake? Good question. Slacker. Like the 7130. It's a great combine. I feel like could have redone the textures on it, though. At least the interior. These textures are from 13. I know they redid the 340 and the 370. I think they might have redone the quad track too. But they didn't redo the combine textures. As we finish up this field, might take a break from beans and switch to corn. Because our last field there, 5 and 9, is one huge soybean field. Last year, Giants released the Pantera sprayer as like a Christmas gift, so since the Pantera is not in game, it'd be kind of funny to see if they release the Pantera as like a holiday gift via email. Gifting the same sprayer over and over. Almost 2 full tanks of our small bean fields. Go back to do corn a little bit. We only have an 8-row header, corn header. We could probably bump that up to a 12. Probably be our next purchase. We don't really grow enough corn to justify getting a 12, but it's probably our slowest part of our operation now is harvesting corn. might be able to afford it if we trade in our 8-row. And if need be, we can take out a small loan too. Some headland work. Yields pretty good. So I believe Jake sold all of our soybeans in our silos, so we should have plenty of storage for that. I'm not quite sure about the corn. There still might be the corn left over from our last harvest. So we may or may not need to pile this. Meridian auger chilling back here. I feel like sugar beets and potatoes could be potentially fun, but the lifting equipment is just so small that you can't really do it on a large scale. slacker. Found him. So our forest of 500 and some trees is fully grown. So that's our money maker right there. That's where we're gonna get our money for bigger equipment. We purchased our scorpion, so we don't have to be in a mad scramble to get as much cut down as we can in an hour, so hopefully that will allow us to be a little bit more organized with our forestry. I wonder if I can cut. We're at 86%. I'm gonna try to make it through to the other side. Out our beans. We'll take care of the combine. The hitch on this tractor is a little high. The grain car looks kind of funny. I was tempted to buy one of my 6R tractors. Hitch that interferes with our front end loader, which is nice, I guess. Standard Giants fashion. I think these are just super ugly tractors, the Pumas. Just everything kind of seems kind of, it's like that teenager that's in the middle of puberty and nothing is proportioned to one another. That's how I would describe the Puma. It's kind of an awkward looking thing. giants horn headers. The amount of detail they put into these things. So look at that. They don't miss anything with these. Nice if they had some gearing off headers. I'm not sure if Capello is more European or not. But you definitely see more gearing off, which doesn't really seem very American to me. See more gearing off horn headers in the States. Anything else really, unless they're running like brand like Case or Deer. Try to go the long way. My way back. I still remember the first day I tried to edit a mod. It was back in FS13. It was like a white Ford long box. I believe it was F350. It was fairly well detailed. Vehicles, trucks, wherever I went. And it had a fifth wheel hitch attacher on it. Every time I would like put a tractor on a gooseneck trailer, it would just like the bottom of the back suspension would just get out. And that really bothered me and I wanted to change it. And this was my first experience ever opening up XML. I literally had no idea what I was looking at. And I remember I was trying to change the spring and dampener settings. And I didn't know what the hell I was doing. So I had to Google spring and dampener. And this is back when the physics in 13 were totally the mass, how they calculated mass of the vehicle wasn't even in kilograms like it is now. Kind of borrow that from the MR engine of drill. I was trying to fix that. And then I was on FS UK reading the threads and stuff like that. Because the next step, I wanted to kind of like change tires on another mod I had, or like make them bigger or something. I forget what it was. And there was all this reference to a note. And I would open up the i3D and the giant set of air. There was nothing called node. It was all transform. So I literally had to Google what node meant and arms. That's how big of a noob. Like, I literally came from square, not even square one, just zero. I started from zero. I didn't know what a node was. I didn't know what a node was referring to. So people are asking, like, how do you do this? How do you do that? And they see the work that I'm doing now, and like, how quickly I'm able to produce it. I think it's just kind of hilarious that I literally was probably the biggest noob history of arms. I started out on American Eagle modding their threads. And though, you know, it seemed like everyone's been playing this game since 2009, at least, whenever the first game was around. So they all kind of like knew what was going on. So it's always, when you're first learning, literally, like, when you're as big a noob as I was, where you know absolutely nothing, all of your basic, super basic questions you're going to have, all your questions you're going to have, I'd say in the first 6 months of learning to mod, have been asked and have been answered, and answered thoroughly and in depth. The threads, so if you just use like search whatever on the threads, use a search function, literally your answer, your question is already answered, you just have to search for it. I get, I have messaging enabled on my modding Facebook page, and I get a lot of questions, a lot of basic questions, even on YouTube. A lot of comments, and I just delete them. A lot of basic entry-level questions that you just, when you're asking them, when you're asking someone those kind of questions, it reflects poorly on you, because it shows the person you're asking that you haven't done your homework, you haven't put in any amount of time or effort. Has been done. So the person you're asking is going to be even less likely going to help you. So that's why I always suggest, some people might say it's a dick move or whatever, but seriously, Google. If you have a question, Google. You'll be surprised how quickly you'll find an answer. Yeah, and, you'll save yourself the embarrassment of asking someone a very basic question. Even when I was a complete novice in this game, I knew enough to use the search functions, because literally there's thousands and thousands of threads. And odds are when you're learning, you're making very simple mistakes. It's not something that's gonna change the face of modding as you know it. It's most likely something's out of order, something's poorly indexed, you're missing a texture. You know, for example, I get asked all the time, why are mods white when I put it in game? I mean, if you were to spend 10 seconds on any thread, you'll find out it's because you want to have an app on the computer. And two, it's, you just have to be simple. You know, when that happens and you're asking questions that have been answered hundreds of times already, you're going to get frustrated because you're going to get ignored 99.9% of the time. If not ignored, you're going to get what seems to be a smart-ass reply. And that doesn't apply to this forum, so that applies to everything. And I guess the biggest thing that kind of prompted me to learn, because it's not an easy process, it's not something you're going to learn overnight. But it's kind of the same thing that's going on, or people, if you go on any threads or any forums or Facebook group, YouTube channel, you'll have people that are always asking for mods, or people saying, hey, you should make this or you should make that. There's always people that want something. Yeah. I remember when I was at that point, I didn't have any ability to make anything myself that was really good. I didn't know how to model, I didn't know how to texture, I didn't know how to UV map. I was usually the process of learning to mod, you start out with maps, to make a simple map out of it. Here's another tidbit, when I was back on the original map in 13, I wanted to remove tree, and I wanted to remove the tree so I can expand the field. And so I was trying to like search threads, and like people are making videos how to move stuff. And I didn't realize when you like would click on a tree, it kind of had like sub. You had like the main transform group, and then there's like rigid bodies within that. And sometimes when you click on an object in the editor, you'll get the like the parent transform and not the whole, or like a child of the transform and not the whole transform itself. So like the visible tree would move, but the actual collisions of the tree wouldn't move. And that drove me absolutely bananas when I was trying to make simple map edits. So that's where I started from. I started from an absolute bottom. I'm not gonna say it's not easy, because I mean it is easy, it's just a little frustrating. It was frustrating to me because if I could mess it up or make a mistake, I definitely did. And that's how you learn, you know, that's how you learn with everything. There's a saying that your best teacher is your last mistake. It's definitely true. Like, if you get questions wrong on exams, or you do something and it's backwards or it's wrong, like, you never forget it. Yeah, so that kind of helps you reduce the learning curve by, you never repeat the same mistake. It also helps you troubleshoot other issues. Been there, done that. What the issue is, you know how to fix it. But working in GE, I think that's where we all kind of start. Either doing simple map edits or trying to kind of like fix things on a mod in Giant's Editor. And then the next step up is actually trying to model, learn to model well. I would say, like, when you're learning to model, you'll probably remodel the same thing at least 10 times minimum. To learn. Like, I've rebuilt mods so many times that you just kind of tell you learn to do it and do it right, and know hidden faces and learn to mark seams while you're making it. It's a long process. Keep it the polys down, but yet still have detail. Texturing is a whole other animal. Learning to make EV maps, spec maps, normal maps, learning how to apply them, save them in the right format. It's all a learning curve. YouTube is great. There's so many YouTube videos out there on Blender. Might not be exactly related to modding and modeling for farm sim, but it really doesn't have to. I mean, a model is a model, UV map is UV mapping, texture is texturing. I've made a good video on how to import and export things out of Blender with materials and textures. I know that thousands of people have watched that. They've learned from it. Which is kind of satisfying, I guess. This game was kind of like locked. Didn't have the ability to personalize it, I would probably would have stopped playing it a long time ago. But in order to truly have fun, I guess get addicted to it, you really have to be a student of the modding and editing process. Otherwise it just gets too boring. So we have just under 70,000 motorcycles. I wish this pipe would come out further too, so we could actually see what you're unloading. Streaming over an hour. That horse maestro, when you set it to the actual working width of 9 meters, it leaves little patches, so if you're using that planter, you might want to knock it back. If you're using GPS, it's like 8.9. Joysticks is kind of boring when you're doing it all by yourself. Have 11.4 hours on this combo. I feel like we've had this for a while now, but I guess harvesting doesn't take that long. And we have quite a bit more hours on our tractors. Switch over to these longer passes. So I'm assuming last season we got about 67,000 liters off this field. Should get roughly the same, since we didn't plow or anything. It's the same size. Sure how much longer I'm going to be live streaming for. Coming up on an hour and a half. Might fill this up and call it a night. Might end up ripping all of our fields since we bought the 2100, 7 meters, 22.5-9 shank. That's a 300 horsepower requirement. Thank you. guys, I think we're gonna end the stream here. So thanks for watching, and I guess like and subscribe for more videos.